So over the past few weeks, thousands of migrant miners have been making their way to the U.S.-Mexico border, trying to cross over into the states. There are so many, though, there is no place left to put them at the border, many of them now on their way to North Texas. Chris Sadeghi joins us live outside the Kay Bailey Hutchinson Convention Center in Dallas this morning. And Chris, a lot of young folks need a lot of help.
Yes, Mark, and that's why some local volunteers have spent the last 24 hours trying to set up this facility. We have a better idea now of how this will work. The first 200 children will be brought here today, children who recently crossed the border by themselves, up to 3,000 total, will ultimately be brought here. Around 2,300 of them are teenage boys from the ages 15 to 17 years old. The convention center has been leased for 75 days to the federal government, and this operation will be run by FEMA and Health and Human Services. The city of Dallas will not be involved with the operation, although the local Red Cross and Catholic Charities of Dallas will help. A similar overflow facility was in Midland, set up there to house 700 immigrants. HHS said the children will stay here while they try to find them family sponsors where they can stay while going through the immigration process. This is happening because facilities at the border are now at capacity, because most of the recent border surge that's also becoming a political border battle. The Biden administration rolled back most of the strict Trump administration's immigration orders, and then the surge seemed to have a noticeable uptick once Biden took office in January. However, border control data also shows the increase actually began around April of 2020 and haven't hit the peak that we saw in May of 2019, although we are on pace to eclipse that mark. Governor Greg Abbott will be here in Dallas today to discuss this facility. He has been very critical of the Biden administration policies that he said led to this humanitarian crisis. Also, he's accused the administration of releasing COVID-positive migrants into the state of Texas. We're told that there will be a COVID screening process that happens here once these migrants arrive. Mark, back to you.
All right, thank you for that, Chris.